Hello friends, welcome to my YouTube channel Chemistry King. Today I will talk to matrix representation of symmetry elements or operations. It is 28A. There are so many lectures on molecular symmetry and the title have been designated as 1, 2, 3, 4. In 28, there are so many parts A, B, 28A, 28B, 28C and so on. Actually, this video is the introduction, only introduction to matrix representation of symmetry elements or operations. In next videos, there will be matrix representation of all symmetry elements one by one. All symmetry elements means identity, center of symmetry, plane of symmetry, and so on. All elements, matrix of symmetry elements, all elements will be shown one by one to make them clear. Okay, friends. Now, what is group theory? First, we should know what is group theory. Mathematical study, look here, mathematical study of symmetry is known as group theory. Here we will see how a symmetry element or operation can be represented as matrix. Here an example has been given of 2x2 matrix. 2x2 matrix means there should be two row. This is first row and this is second row. There are two row and also two column, 1 and 2. Then 2x2 matrix reveals that there should be two rows and two columns. Okay? And that's why this example has been said to be 2x2 matrix. If a matrix contains one and only one row, it is called row matrix. And if a matrix contains, includes one and only one column, it is called column matrix. Okay. Now we consider a coordinate system XYZ. Friends, it is X, it is Y and it is Z. Okay. And we apply identity operation, this identity operation to this coordinate system. Then XYZ changes to XYZ means no change is observed. Identity operation means this coordinate system is rotated by 360. Then it will rotate and again will come here. It will rotate by 360 and again it will come here. And this Z will remain as such always at any moment of rotation. Then, when identity operation is applied on this coordinate system, there will be no change. Now, C2 operation is applied to this system. C2 operation, this is X, this is Y, and this is Z. Okay? And C2 operation means, suppose it is Z-axis. It is Z-axis. Okay? And the coordinate system is rotated by 180. As I told, it is C2 axis, then it should be rotated by 180 degree. By rotation of 180 degree, here you are looking here, C2 Z. This Z means Z is the C2 axis, okay? And X, Y, Z changes into minus X, minus Y, and Z. How? When this coordinate system is rotated by 180 degree around this Z axis, then what will happen? This X will come here back. It will be minus X. And this Y will come here. This Y will come here. Means it is minus Y. It is minus Y. And this Z will not change. This Z does not change. It remains always as such. And this is why I have written here XYZ has changed to minus X, minus Y and Z. Okay, friends? Now, sigma XZ, here you are looking sigma XZ. Sigma XZ is applied to this coordinate system. Friends, I have told you it is X, it is Y and it is Z. Sigma XZ is a plane. It is X, it is Z. Means you are putting a plane in this fashion, in this manner. When it is a plane, then what are you observing? This plane comprises of X and Z, means X and Z do not change. Only this Y, you are looking here, it is Y. Look at here, it is Y. When this is a mirror plane, this Y will be reflected here. Means Y changes to minus Y. And this is why I have written here XYZ changes to X minus Y and Z. Again, I am repeating here, this is a plane. Friends, this is X, this is Z, and this is the XZ plane. And this plane comprises of, this plane includes X and Z, means X and Z do not change. Only this Y changes to minus Y. X changes to X, Y changes to minus Y, Z changes to Z. Means X and Z do not change, only Y changes to minus Y. Okay, friends, now we will see the matrix representation of different symmetry elements or operations one by one in incoming videos. It is, friends, just introduction to matrix representation of element. Matrix representation of each element will be shown in incoming videos. Thank you. Bye. See you again.